Mimi G here with another tutorial as part of the Mimi G for Michael Levine collaboration. Today's sew along is going to be for this Vogue 8930 blanket coat. Let's talk over the tools we need to get started. You're of course going to need some basic tools like scissors for your fabric and scissors for your paper, a disappearing ink marker for any markings you might need to transfer from your paper pattern to your fabric, pins, a seam ripper, pattern weights. I just use big washers from my local home improvement store, coordinating thread, and of course, our pattern. For this coat, you're going to need a medium weight wool. You could also use a fleece. You could use a wool felt, and you could also use a tweed. You will also need some lining fabric, which you can use a solid or maybe even a fun print, like I'm gonna use a polka dot. Now, for the amount of fabric you're going to need, you just simply need to read the back of the pattern envelope and choose your size and then follow the guide, which will tell you exactly how much fabric you're going to need for your project, including how much lining fabric you're also going to need. Let's go over the pattern pieces you need to cut out. Now, the first one that you're going to need to cut out is piece number 2, which is the front and also the facing. We're doing view C, which has a lining. You're also going to need to cut out number 4, which is the back of our coat. You're also going to need to cut out number 6 out of your fashion fabric, and piece number 5, which is our sleeve. Now I want you to take note that on the pattern pieces, it will let you know to cut 2 of fabric and 2 of lining. For example, for your sleeve, you will need to cut out 2 of your fashion fabric and 2 out of lining fabric. For number 6, which is our pocket, you're going to cut out 2 of your fashion fabric and 2 out of your lining. For number 4, you're going to cut out 1 of your fashion fabric on the fold as marked on your pattern piece, and you're also going to cut 1 more on the fold out of lining fabric. Now, for pattern piece number 2, you're going to cut 4 pieces out of fashion fabric, because this will also be the facing of our jacket, which means when you turn your collar over, it needs to be the same fabric on both sides. So for pattern piece number 2, make sure that you cut all 4 pieces out of your fashion fabric. Generally, we fold our fabric lengthwise with right sides facing and selvage edges meeting. Now, inside of your pattern envelope, in your instructions, you will see some cutting layouts. This will guide you as to how to lay your pattern pieces out onto your fabric to maximize the use of your fabric. So, for example, this says to place it on the fold of your fabric. So, my fabric is folded with right sides facing. The fold is towards me. So, I would lay my pattern piece with the edge along the fold of my fabric, and I would use my pattern weights to hold my pattern piece in place. As I mentioned earlier, I have already cut out all of my pattern pieces out of my fashion fabric, which is this beautiful red wool fabric that I'm using. Now I want to make sure that you transfer all of your markings and notches before we get to sewing. So for example, as you can see, this is my pattern piece number 2, which is cut out. My fabric is underneath my tissue. And you will notice all these little notches and dots, and these are all markings that need to be transferred. So what I do is I take my scissors, and wherever I see a notch, I make a very small snip, maybe less than 1/4 of an inch. And I snip into all of my notches. These notches help us during the construction process because they let you know which piece goes to which piece. So I want you to clip all of your notches, and anywhere that you see a dot, I want you to use your fabric marker and make a little dot in all of those areas. Do that for all of your pattern pieces, and then make sure to review that you've transferred all of those markings. Now that all your pieces have been cut, grab anything that was cut out of your fashion fabric and let's start sewing. We're going to start with pattern piece number 2, of which we cut 4 out of our fashion fabric, and we're going to work with 2 of them now. So what I want you to do is I want you to take the edge that has the 3 notches, okay, that's the center back of our jacket, and I want you to pin at your notches and then again at the top and at the bottom, and we're going to sew these together using 5/8 of an inch seam allowance. And you're going to backstitch the beginning We're using my daughter's sewing machine today, which she's very excited about. Now I'm using a white thread so you guys can see it, but you should be using a coordinating thread. Now I want you to press this seam open. Give that a good press so it's nice and flat. And then you're going to grab your back pattern piece, which is also cut out of your fashion fabric. Okay, I have pressed my center back seam open, and as you can see, I have these slits here in the corners. Now on your pattern piece, you had a little dot that you should have marked, and so you're going to snip all the way up until you get to that dot. So that's why you see these little slashes here, which you should also have. Now I'm going to take my back piece, and at the neck, I'm going to pin my center back of my back piece to the center back of my collar, and I'm going to pin there first. And then I'm going to pin the shoulder, which is this part here, and your matches should match up. I'm going to pin there, and then I'll pin here. And I'm going to align this. As you can see, there's going to be a little bit of a corner there. We want that to split because we're attaching the collar to our neck. So we're going to pin. And then I'm going to pin the other side. And you'll have this little V here. And what we do is we sew until we get here, and then we sew all the way across. So you're going to pin the other side the same way, match your notch, pin at the end. Now we're going to start at one shoulder, and you want this little V to be facing up so that you can see it as you're sewing. And we're using 5/8 of an inch all the way across. There's going to be a little bit of a fold here. You're going to sew right till you get to that, the end of that slit. Backstitch. And then lift your presser foot, and you're just going to pivot and continue to sew. Once you're done sewing, you're going to go ahead and trim this to 3/8 of an inch, all the way across. Now that we have our back and our front attached at the shoulders. And now we have our collar. We can attach our sleeve to the front. So what you're going to do is we're going to be working with the side. And I want you to take your sleeve, one sleeve, and with right sides facing, my fabric is the same on both sides, so it doesn't really matter, but I'm going to align my center notch on my sleeve to my shoulder seam, and I'm going to pin there first. And then I'm going to make sure that I am aligning the two notches. This is the back of my jacket, the back of my sleeve. And we're going to pin the single notch on the front. And we're going to sew starting 5/8 of an inch from the edge of our sleeve. Back stitch. Since we started 5/8 of an inch from the edge, we're going to stop 5/8 of an inch from the edge of our sleeve. And back stitch. Now we have one sleeve attached, and you're going to do the same thing for the other side. Now that we have our sleeves attached on both sides, before we sew the sides of our coat up, we're going to attach our pockets. And so I want you to first press your seams for your sleeves towards the hem of your sleeve. Give that a good press. And working on the back of your coat, not the front pieces, but only the back, you're going to attach your fabric pocket pieces, not your lining pocket pieces. So what you're going to do is you're going to align the notch that is on your pocket with the notch that is on the back of your jacket. Go ahead and pin. And we're going to sew it using a 1/4 inch seam allowance. And you're going to do the same thing to the other side of your back jacket. You're going to pin your fabric sleeve or fabric pocket, matching your notch. And you're going to sew using a 1/4 inch seam allowance. Now, working on the front of our jacket, we're going to align our pocket lining pieces to the notch on our front jacket. Align your notch, pin, and we're going to sew it the same way that you did the fabric pockets on both sides. As you can see, I have sewn my lining pocket to the front of my jacket, and I have sewn the fashion fabric pocket to the back of my jacket, so yours should be the same. And now we're going to sew up the entire side seam, including our sleeve. So what you're going to do first is I want you to press your pocket flat so that your seam allowance is facing the pocket and everything is nice and pressed. And what you're going to do is we're going to start at the pocket first. So we're going to pin where the pockets meet at the top. And then we're going to pin our pocket, matching up the notches. And then maybe one more time for good measure. And then starting at the bottom of our coat, we're going to pin at the hem. And pin at the bottom where our pocket ends. And we're going to continue up the sleeve. So I want you to match your underarm seams. And then pin your sleeve at the hem. And then maybe one more in between. And now we're going to sew in one continuous seam. And we're going to break at the pocket and then continue. So let's start at the sleeve and using 5/8 of an inch seam allowance. Backstitch at the beginning. It gets a little thick in some areas, so go slow. I don't want you to break your needle. And we're going to sew until we meet the stitching of our sleeve. Put your needle in, lift your presser foot, and you're going to pivot. And now we're going to sew down the sides till about 5/8 of an inch past our pocket. Now you're going to pivot again, so lift your presser foot with your needle in. And we're going to sew our pocket. Put your needle in and pivot again. And now we're going to sew the rest of the way down, also in that 5/8 of an inch seam allowance. And now we've sewn all the way through our sleeve and down, leaving a pocket opening. So when you turn your jacket right side out, big jacket to be working with, but you can see our pocket. Okay, now that we've sewn together the sides and our sleeve, our jacket is pretty much done, except for now we need to construct the lining and then attach the lining to the jacket. So one quick thing that I want to have you do is underneath your arm, we're going to have a little bit of a bulky area here. So what I like to do is I snip into it without getting too close to my stitching, and I just trim off some of that bulk. And it's completely optional, but you should always trim and remove as much bulk as you can. So turn your jacket right side out. You're going to set it aside, and you're going to construct your lining the same exact way we just did the jacket, except for the pockets. You're not going to be adding pockets to your lining because we've already done that. As you can see, I've already sewn my lining together. So this would be a good time to attach your lining and then go ahead and add a label if you have one. If you want to add your label to it, that'd be cool. And as you can see, I've already sewn down the sides. And I left one opening on one side seam. And the reason I did that is because we're going to bag our lining, meaning when we attach our lining to our coat, we're going to need an opening so that we can turn our jacket right side out again after we're done. So I want you to leave an opening on one side seam of your lining, just the way that I did here. And on the other side, you can just sew it all the way from your sleeve all the way down your side seams with no opening and, of course, no pocket. We are going to pin our lining to our jacket with right sides facing. So I have my lining laid out. This is the center back seam of our neck,
as you can see. And now I'm going to lay my jacket over the top, matching my seams. So I'm going to first pin at the center back seam of both my lining and my jacket. And you'll kind of need a little space for this because it's quite a bit of fabric we're working with. And you're going to go ahead and pin all the way down your collar in different places. Until you get to your hem. And this is going to be all one continuous seam, so you want to pin so that you don't get all your fabric misaligned. So you want to pin wherever you can. And we're also going to pin down the hem of our jacket. So I'm going to turn this over. As you can see, this is the hem of our coat, and we're going to pin, making sure to align our side seams. Basically, we're pinning all the way around the outer edge of our jacket. Align again your other side seam. And then maybe once in the middle here of your hem. And then you're going to continue on to the other side and then up the front collar until you meet back at the center back seam of your collar. Now that we have pinned around the entire collar, the front of our jacket, and across the bottom of our hem, we're going to sew starting on one side, and then we're going to stop and then continue on from the other side all the way down. So we're going to start at the center back of our collar where we sewed those together. Using 5/8 of an inch seam allowance, we're going to sew backstitch. And then continue all the way around. We're now reaching the bottom of our jacket, so you're going to sew and then lift, and we're going to sew across the bottom of our jacket, our hem. Sew until you get to the center. Backstitch. And now you're going to turn your jacket around to the other side. And you're going to do the same thing starting at the center back. And you're going to sew all the way down until you meet the center of your hem. Alright, we're going to turn our coat right side out through this opening that we left. So just basically stick your hand in there and we're going to pull it out. But first I want you to clip the corners where your hem, at the bottom where your hem is, and where the front of the jacket meet. Because you just want a nice pointy corner, so you want to remove some of that excess. And you do that for both corners. And now stick your hand in through here and gently start to pull the jacket out. And for your corners, put your hand in through the opening and then just push out the corners. And you can use a point turner if you have one, or anything sharp, just don't cut through or pierce your fabric. Now we of course need to press this. So I want you to take it to your ironing table and I want you to press all the way around your jacket. So make sure that you have your seams nice and flat and press all the way around. And then you're going to also press down the hem of your jacket and give that a good press before we move further. Now that you've pressed all the way around your jacket, we need to close this opening. And so the fastest way to do it without hand stitching is to grab both pieces, your lining and your fashion fabric, and you're going to pin, kind of pressing that together. And we're just going to sew really close to the edge. So turn under the 5/8 of an inch on both sides and pin. And then go ahead and put it under your machine. I'm sewing about 1/8 of an inch from the edge, from the folded edge. You're going to close this opening. And now you've got that closed section of your lining. And go ahead and snip your threads. And now we can move on to our sleeves. Now the only thing left to do is for us to finish the sleeve. So what we're gonna do is turn your jacket, your coat, wrong side out. So you're looking at your lining. And what we're gonna do first is, this is the only place really where you're going to slip stitch or have to do any hand sewing. You're first going to turn over the hem of your sleeve. So I'm turning over 7/8 of an inch. And I'm going to sew this first. So starting at my seam, we have this part done, we're going to create a stitching line around our lining. And this will just help you know exactly where to fold over and where to pin and where to stitch when you're hand sewing. So I'm going to use just a little wider than 7/8 of an inch because I want it to peek, not to peek from underneath my sleeve. And I'm going to just stitch all the way around. I'm not folding anything over. I'm just creating a stitching line. Any loose threads. And now what you're going to do is you're going to press this. Using your iron, you're going to press this to the inside so that you have a nice crisp pressed edge, and then we're going to pin it to our sleeve. So go ahead and press this all the way around. Now that you've pressed your edge on your lining, what we're going to do is we're going to line up our seams, and we're going to put the pressed edge along the stitching line that we have on our fashion fabric. So go ahead and start to pin. And this is just a really great way of making sure that it's even all the way around and you end up with a clean finish. And just continue using the folded edge against your stitching line on your fashion fabric as your guide. And you're going to do that for both sleeves. And once you have it pinned, you're going to take your needle and thread. You're going to make a knot at the end of one end. And you're going to sew all the way around. So you're just going to grab a couple of stitches of your fashion fabric and a couple of threads on your lining. And you're going to sew this closed all the way around. Taking tiny little bites of both your fashion fabric and your lining fabric. And continue all the way around until you reach your starting point and you are all done. If you want to make the optional belt, you can cut two pieces of fabric that are about 40 inches long and 4 inches wide, and we're going to join them. And you can make it as short or as long as you want, really. I just like for my belts to be a little long, so I'm going to join them together at one end. And go ahead and press this flat on the inside. And then you're going to turn it over. And I'm going to pin. And starting in one, at the center where the seam is, you're going to sew all the way down using a 1/4 inch seam allowance. And we're going to sew to the end and then pivot and close it out and then turn it over and do the same thing again. We're going to leave an opening on the other side. And then you're going to pivot when we get to the end, about a 1/2 inch before the end of our belt. And then we're going to do the same thing on the other side, except we're going to leave about 1.5 inches opening. And then you're going to sew all the way down and close it up just the way we did on the other side. Once you're done sewing the other side, you're going to use a point turner if you have one. You can even use a pencil. And you're just going to push this through. And you're going to continue to push it through all the way around. I'm not using my pointy side because I don't want it to pierce my fabric. And you'll continue to push this all the way through until you reach your opening, and you'll pull your fabric out through that 1-inch opening we left. And push your fabric all the way through, or pull your fabric all the way through. And then you can remove your pointer or pencil or whatever you used. And you'll do the same thing to the other side. Once you turn it right side out, go ahead and press it like I have here, and we're going to stitch all the way around the edge. So starting at the center where we have our stitching, our seam line, we're going to sew 1/4 inch all the way around.
I hope you guys have enjoyed this tutorial, and I can't wait to see all of your amazing coats. I'll talk to you soon. Peace.